Hi everyone, so today's look is going to be a very dramatic blue smoky eye, and I absolutely love this look. I think it's just so fun and bright and just so gorgeous for the spring and summer. And also, I know that prom is coming up, so if you want to do something a little bit daring, you can go ahead and try out this look. And I really love all the colors in this look. I think they remind me of like mermaids and the beach and just the ocean, and I just love them so much. And also, you guys know that I always use drugstore products in my tutorials, so I decided to kind of switch it up a bit and use something more high-end. And in this video, almost all of the eyeshadows I'll be using is the Rock and Republic eyeshadows. I've had these for quite a while, but I've always just kind of put them aside and never used them, and then recently I have rediscovered them, and it turns out that I really, really do like them, so I've decided to use some of them in the tutorial. So I hope you guys like this, and if you want to see how I do it, then stay tuned. I'm going to first prime my eyes using the e.l.f. Mineral Eyeshadow Primer. I'm going to blend it out all over the lid and also under the lower lash line. Next, I'm applying a white base to make the colors appear brighter. This is just NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in Milk. The first Rock and Republic eyeshadow I'm using is called Scene, which is a bluish-purple periwinkle color. I'm just going to apply this all over the lid using a flat shader brush from e.l.f. The next eyeshadow is a greenish-blue color called Brink. I'm going to apply this color in the crease using a fluffy brush from Sedona Lace. Next, I'm taking a blending brush to blend out all the harsh edges. I'm going to also blend where the two colors meet. The next color is a gorgeous bright blue called Electric. I'm going to apply this color to the outer corner. So starting with a V shape, I'm going to start feathering in the color and also bringing it up and into the crease. Next, go ahead and blend out the color for a seamless transition. The last color I'm going to be using is a shimmery white eyeshadow from e.l.f. called Ivory. I'm going to apply this under the brow bone and also bringing it down into the inner tear duct. For the bottom lash line, I'm taking a deep dark blue color and applying it about one-third of the way in. Next, I'm taking the second color Brink and blending it into the previous color. And next to that, I'm going to take the first color and apply it next to that. And then lastly, I'm going to apply the white color into the inner part of the eyes to create a fading effect. Then I'm going to take this black eyeliner pencil from Milani and tightline the upper lash line to give the illusion of a thicker and fuller lash line. And tightlining is basically just lining that flap of skin underneath your upper lash line. I'm then going to take a bluish green pencil liner and line my lower lash line. Next, I'm going to curl my natural lashes with the e.l.f. Eyelash Curler, and then I'm going to apply some demi lashes. And I just simply cut a full lash into half. Next, I'm topping it off with some mascara to blend the natural and fake lashes together. I'm then going to take a liquid liner from L'Oreal to go over the lash band. For the rest of the face, I'm going to contour my cheekbones with the NYC bronzer in Sunny, and then I'm going to apply a light peachy color from e.l.f. called Candid Coral to the cheeks. And as for lips, I'm just going to be using a pinky nude color from Revlon called Peach Petal. And that completes the entire look. For more pictures, please visit my blog listed in the description bar below. Bye guys!